Thank you. So it's your lot's turn to be the warriors of darkness, is it? It's funny how things work out. Well, I did warn you. I followed you to Yulmore and then on to Armarang. And I was there when you slew the Light Warden. Those white-haired twins who are with you. I remember them from our battle in the Source. Are they your friends then? Through thick and thin. Aye. Then I suggest you keep them close. It's when you charge ahead trying to save someone else that you end up losing those you love. Not that you need telling, I'll bet you've lost plenty. But I wonder, what will it cost you this time? I don't remember when it was that I learned regret wasn't worth the bother. You get numb to it all over the years. The lost comrades, the broken promises, the abandoned principles. Just more nagging burdens to ignore.
So this is what the light was hiding. He's here. I must go to him.
Intruders! Fan out and find them!
Out of my way!
Stay your weapon. We are not your enemy. When the alarm sounded, I wondered what we had done to betray our presence. But I see now we are not the only intruders. Sir Estinian, I presume. The dragoon who plucked the Warrior of Light from the jaws of death. Your armor is most distinct.
Much as yours once was. But even without it, I see a former legator still has eyes and ears in unexpected places. Van Baelsar, in the flesh. Though I understand you prefer Shadow Hunter.
You are in contact with the Scions, I take it.
Through no choice of my own. They tracked me down and conscripted me to their cause. I swear their receptionist was trained as a spy. Not that anyone can escape that Baldessian woman once she has caught the scent of your ether.
If they have resorted to using freelancers, I must assume their attempts to wake the afflicted have failed. And what of their champion?
Away on another business. Thus, it has fallen to me to root out any trace of the Empire's new weapon.
Black Rose you seek, you are too late. My people have already completed your mission here. Yet this is but one factory among many. When they caught wind of our efforts, they built additional facilities to ensure production continues unabated. There will be no one left in the lands they conquer. No citizens to conscript. No skills to exploit. Nothing the Empire needs. And they will call it victory.
What exactly does this Black Rose do?
The gas is described as a poison, but its actual effect is more arcane in nature. It was created to disrupt the ether in living beings, to bring the flow of their life energies to a standstill. Inhaling even the tiniest amount will cause all bodily functions to cease, much as a potent venom will stop a man's heart. Released over a city, Black Rose could conceivably kill every inhabitant, and all without damaging a single structure.
Search every corner! Rouse the barracks if you have to! I want this facility secured!
I have more questions, but now is not the time.
Sir Estinian, I have an offer for you, but I will make it only once. Since it would seem we seek the same answers, you are welcome to join us.
From what I hear, you need all the help you can get. In case you don't know, Varys himself confessed that your empire was a creation of the Ascians.
I am aware of what his Radiance said at the parley. Thus, I would return to the capital, that I might behold the truth of this corruption with my own eyes. My path leads to Garlemald.
You have come at a good time. As you may have heard, we have something of a quandary on our hands. Laxan Loft here in Lakeland. Yulmore has sent one of its airships. They have questions for us concerning the death of the Light Warden. Their emissary makes his way here even as we speak.
I suppose the sky does rather give the game away.
Indeed. 'Twas inevitable they would come knocking. The only question was how soon.
My lord, I am come with the Yulmoran emissary. May I show him in?
A moment, Captain, if you would. Everyone, gather around. I do not wish to show our hand prematurely. Forgive me this liberty. Vanish. Enter. Well, well. The commander of the Yulmoran army himself. To what do I owe the honor, General Ranjit?
The Light Warden is dead, Exarch. We owe people responsible.
You are clearly in some haste, my lord. But before I address your question, you must allow me one of my own. What is Yulmor's interest in this?
His benevolence, Lord Vorthry, is gravely concerned that the actions of an ignorant few may jeopardize relations between man and Sin Eater. Should it transpire that the Crystarium is guilty of abetting the villains responsible for this outrage, my lord has decreed that it suffer the same retribution.
I see. Since you have been so candid, I too shall speak my mind. Regardless of who is responsible, the Crystarium rejoices in the Light Warden's death and welcomes the return of the Night Sky. If Yulmor considers this tantamount to aiding those you term villains, then by all means, carry out your retribution. Know, however, that even should every innocent soul in the Crystarium perish, nothing can stop that which has been set in motion.
Folly. The death of one or a thousand Sin-Eaters changes nothing. The world is dead. And writhe as we might, like maggots in its rotting course, it will not be reborn. Only by my master's grace may we live out our days in peace. But I waste my breath. You have made your stance clear. I shall relay your words to Lord Vorthry. In the meantime, you would do well to counsel any here who have done more than merely rejoice in recent events to throw themselves upon Yulmor's mercy, promptly. One last matter. We are searching for a young artist and his assistant. Know you of whom I speak?
An artist and his assistant, no. I cannot say I do.
What a pity. Should they reveal themselves to you, I bid you hand them over at once. My master is most eager to see them again.
Am I imagining things, or did he just stare straight at us?
I fear he did. The General is not a man to be trifled with. He is a warrior of fearsome repute who has led Yulmor's army since before Vorthry's time, when the nation still spearheaded the fight against the Sin-Eaters. One does not command the world's mightiest army, and for so long, without possessing exceptional instincts.
If Yulmor chose to send such an individual, we must assume this talk of retribution is more than an idle threat. While we are grateful for your support, my lord, we cannot, in good conscience, put your people in harm's way.
'Tis noble of you to say, Master Alphino, but my people have been in harm's way since long before you arrived. Yulmor has ever yearned to rule over what remains of the world. Even should we surrender the Warrior of Darkness to them, they would find some other pretext upon which to invade. The people of the Crystarium know this only too well, which is why, when the time comes, I am certain they will fight to the last man. If truth be told, I would not have been surprised had Runjeet declared war here and now.
He may have reason to delay. According to reports, the Yulmoran forces at Luxonloft were observed taking a prisoner. A young woman believed to be none other than the Oracle of Light, Minfilia. It may be that General Runjeet wishes to convey her to Yulmor before commencing hostilities. Having mentored generations of Minfilias, it would not surprise me if he had made her capture his chief concern.
Ah, of course. How remiss of me. I had intended to speak to you of Minfilia. There is, however, much to say, and precious little time in which to say it. I think it best that you seek out Moren at the Cabinet of Curiosity. He'll be able to enlighten you. Alphino, Alize, would you care to accompany your friend? You doubtless have insights of your own to offer on the matter.
All right, though I'm still not sure I understand it all myself.
In the meantime, I will set about making provisions for war. You were doubtless eager to attempt Minfilia's rescue, and with your combined strength, you may well succeed. But as I said earlier, I do not wish to show our hand unless absolutely necessary. It was not merely the night sky that you restored to us, but hope. Hope for the future of Norvrend. Unlike you, we cannot contend with the Light Wardens, but so long as hope burns in our hearts, we will fight on regardless. This I will prove to you. My friends, I thank you for gathering at such short notice. There is something I would ask you all. As many of you are aware, I received an emissary from Yulmor a short while ago in the form of General Ranjit. To my dismay, the general condemned the slaying of the Light Warden and warned me in no uncertain terms that should the Crystarium cast its lot with the Warrior of Darkness, there would be war. Let none be mistaken, we would be hard-pressed indeed to resist the might of Yulmor. Some would even call it suicide. And yet my heart cries out to fight. Better that than relinquish the hope that swelled in my breast when I beheld the night sky for the first time in 100 years. Or so says my heart. My mind, meanwhile, reminds me that to follow my heart would be to risk everything we have accomplished thus far. Clearly, this is not a decision to be made lightly, nor less alone. And so I put the question to you all. What should we do?
My lord, you already know our minds. It brought tears to our eyes to witness the Knight's return. The whole of Norvrand deserves the same, and not just because some children's story tells us so.
Yulmor's influence is far-reaching. Should war break out, trade would be subject to restrictions. The flow of goods will dry up. And we will struggle to make do with what little trickles through.
Aye, we can weather such hardships. Is that not the very thing the Crystarium was built for? We have always taken pride in our ability to sustain ourselves. Not just to endure, but to thrive.
When all falls down around you, rise up. Those were your words. There may come a day when all hope seems lost. But even should the rest of the world give in to despair, we shall not. We shall fight on, that our children and our children's children might know a better tomorrow.
Rousing words apart, I never much cared for those Yulmoran bastards anyway. No better than common swindlers, most of them. Wouldn't know a fair deal if it came up and kissed them on the arse.
Trust you to spoil the moment.
It appears we have a consensus. Let it be known that the Yulmoran host at Laxanloft has taken the Oracle of Light captive. They fear the power she holds over the Sin Eaters, and doubtless intend to imprison her once more. So, I move that we rescue the Oracle, grant her a place among us, and let that be our answer to Yulmor's ultimatum.
Hear, hear!
Hear, hear!
In planning a strategy for the rescue, I open the floor to you all.
And there you have it. If Yulmore wishes to denounce us as villains, then we shall embrace our villainy. Will you do so as well?
We will not be outdone. Consider us your partners in crime.
My lord, our proposal is as follows. We begin by deploying Amuro to occupy the skies over Lakeland. They should serve to delay the airship's departure. At the same time, we scatter dream powder from the air. Not all will succumb to its effects, but it should thin the enemy's numbers, affording us an opening to swoop in and liberate the Oracle.
Very good. Cease your preparations.
And what exciting crimes would you have us commit? Speaking for my fellow villains, I'd say we're capable of most things, though we draw the line at indolence.
If excitement is your desire, then I bid you join the guard. Captain Lena will give you your orders.
keep moving. What now?
The Crysterium, I guess. Desperate fools. It'd take more than a handful of overgrown lizards to ground us.
Let us free the Oracle from their clutches.
Leave this to me! We'll be right back.
humanity! Be gone! You, boy, you bear a striking resemblance to the artist my master seeks. By all means, keep your counsel. You will all have ample time to confess your crimes back in Yule.
you would see your city razed.
I would sooner see it razed than conquered. Suffice it to say, we are ready to receive you.
What now, Exarch? Will you face me yourself?
I think not, General. I've quite exhausted my tricks. If you mean to give chase, I will not stand in your way. But you would do well to tread warily, for your quarry goes to a place where even Yulmor dare not bear its steel. Ilmeg, the Fairy Kingdom.
Mountain of Indolence still had the energy to unleash his hounds.
Even the most pointless of conflicts may alter a world's course. And now the plan has gone awry.
But how? How did the so-called Crystal Exarch bring the hero of the Source to the First?
As if I didn't have enough on my hands already. Then again, with a soul such as that, mayhap there is another way. One which does not require bloodshed.
Not so long ago, here in the shadow of the northern ranges, lay the great kingdom of Verbert. A nation with a proud history that the Sin Eaters cut short, just like all the rest. Since that time, these lands have become a haven for fey folk. Dreamers frolicking amidst the ruins of a forgotten realm.
We should be safe enough here. It's good to see you again, my friends. I don't know about you, but it feels like years since last we met. 5 of them in my case.
Why, it only feels like 1 to me, but long enough to warrant a more convivial reunion either way. What brought you to Laxan Loft?
The girl, Minfilia. She and I were traveling together, hunting Sin Eaters. But as we were nearing Lakeland, she abruptly ran off on her own. I found her too late to stop the Yulmorans from taking her prisoner. And as I was considering rescue options, I observed that the Crystarium was on the move. So I consulted the Exarch, who apprised me of the details of the operation and issued me certain instructions. Should the situation take a turn for the worse, I was to see you all safely to Ilmeg. And here we are.
Orianger has called this place home for a while now, yet we have never called upon him, I am ashamed to say. 'Twas only at the Crystarium that we met.
Hardly surprising. This is not the sort of place one visits on a whim. Happily, having trespassed on Orianger's hospitality for a spell, Minfilia and I have an idea of how things work around here. Sooner or later, the Yulmorans will come after us. But before they do, the Exarch bids us accomplish 2 things. first, rendezvous with Orianger. And second, eliminate the Light Warden of this land.
So, Minfilia, what made you leave Thancred behind, if you don't mind me asking?
You, the hero from another world. I was asleep when I felt it. A presence. Someone I was meant to meet. They were close and... and I knew I had to go to them. But with all the commotion in Lakeland, I was afraid that Thancred wouldn't let me.
And would I have been wrong? Had I arrived a moment later, you would be back in your cell in Yulmore. And now we have Ranjit snapping at our heels. You really have outdone yourself this time.
I'm sorry. Thank you for saving me.
Oh, poor thing being scolded so.
Who said that? Show yourselves!
Come now! Put away that frown and have some fun with us!
Yes, let's have some fun! Lots and lots of fun!
Which way was it to Orianger's?
We've been there so many times, but I'm not... I can't... why can't I remember?
Damn it all. We're already caught in their spell.
Farasitha, Krakleath.
No! We're found! How did this mortal know our trick?
Wait! I recognize their souls! These two have been here before!
Look, look, twins! How adorable!
Aww!
Play with us!
We have neither the time nor inclination to play. We have come to see Urianje.
Oh, yes, Urianje, the peculiar one! In return for a place in Elmeg, he agreed to a riddle contest with us for 7 days and 7 nights without any sleep.
Oh, that was so much fun. We must do it again.
I'm sure he'd be delighted. Now, if you'd be so kind as to lift your spell.
Shall we?
Should we?
Would we?
What now?
I don't know, but this is their home, so we must indulge them.
Right, we've made up our minds. We will lift our spell on one condition, that you first lend us a helping hand, or two, or three. Once you've helped solve all of our troubles, we'll let you see Urianje. Pixie's honor!
Well, there you have it. Pixie chores.